I was scared.
Me too.
Weren't we all?
That's all you have to say.
I have to say, I was crying the whole time.
We heard nothing. We were distracted.
Only if you were by the door. We were not by the door at all.
Wait, what is it again?
North side.
And who's at north side? That's where my sister goes. We heard nothing. We were distracted by playing in
cars. Are the sheds
everywhere?
The McDonald's sign, like somewhere over here, is like destroyed. Completely. Almost every McDonald's was standing except for the sign.
Was flooded.
When you start to go over the bridge, there's a place that had nothing on it.
The bridge got flooded. One of the trees fell in front of our house.
It started with like eight
covering
of
the building.
Nothing happened to our house.
Storm, there was like 40 of us. Because we had to save people from the
Hurricane Michael didn't affect my house, but it affected my cousin's house, and now I have extra people living in my house. And so for Thanksgiving, we had our whole family that usually eats at my grandparents' house eat at our house, and it affected my neighborhood because I live in the cove, and it affected the neighborhood, and we don't have a lot of trees left.
Again later today, if it be more water damage, we'll take more out. Okay?
So it just really depends
on the water.
Okay. I'm gonna take it.
We head this way.
We are serving hot meals every day. We're also handing out tarps for people to put over their houses. Buckets that are cleaning kits, if I got a bucket so they have a whole bunch of cleaning stuff in them, and cases of water. And Mr. B and our other lady friend over there, they're making meals inside. We actually are cooking meals over at the other side of the bridge. We've supplied about 10,000 hot meals a day.
The Springfield Fire Department. Your question was, how much damage have I seen? Some houses are barely touched, some are totally destroyed. The city that we live in now is a lot different than it was 3 weeks ago. And it's gonna take a while to rebuild.
until actually about 2 hours into it when it started really getting rough. And then after the eye hit and it started really getting bad to where I have never been so scared in my life. I had a wall bust out in front of me. I watched my house breathe. And that was pretty scary.
During Hurricane Michael, I felt bad because most people lost their houses. And this destroyed Panama City. Panama City was amazing. And it got destroyed by Hurricane Michael. And no, my house didn't really have any damages.
We were here along with 8 others. And we were here while everything was going on. And it was a very devastated hurricane. A lot of wind, a lot of rain, a lot of damage. We rode it out. But if we had to do it again, I don't think we would ride out one that if we knew it would be as devastating as it was. You're going to have to get a bar.
I'm gonna ask you a few questions. What does being Panhandle Strong mean to you?
For me, it means just overcoming, you know, challenges in life.
What was your experience during the storm?
So my experience, I didn't get to go home for 6 days. So the biggest struggle for me was not being able to see my family.
How do you feel when you first got Wi-Fi, water, and electricity?
It makes you appreciate what you have. That you take for granted. I mean, it's a big boost, you know, to it helps you just get right again, you know, like you're feeling down in the dump one day, but when you can take a hot shower and, you know, get running water and not having to get it out of a bucket, it makes you appreciate things more.
Would you evacuate next time?
I'll go wherever help is needed.
How has the experience been trying to rebuild your home?
I didn't have a lot of damage to my house. I live in Ebro. The only thing that we experienced was a tree fell on one of our sheds. It's not that.
What does Panhandle Strong mean to you?
Panhandle Strong means that we are all in this together. Everyone who lives experienced the storm, that we help each other. When anybody needs anything, we're there to help. That's what we do because we're strong together.
What was the experience during the storm for you?
Well, I was by myself and I had 2 dogs that were very old and I wouldn't leave my house because of my 2 dogs. And so we went actually and we sat in my pantry. I didn't eat for 3 days. I don't know if you did, but I wasn't very hungry at all. I just wanted to drink water, water, water. And so after 3 days, I went to a place where they had a truck that came from Missouri and brought 10,000 cases of water to hand out to people who didn't have any because I had already either drank mine or given it away.
Would you evacuate next time?
Probably.
What was the experience of rebuilding your house?
Well, I'm still in that process, and it's a slow process getting contractors there, people that can do the work, that are willing to do the work, that show up on time, that charge fair prices, that do good work. It's hard to find.
Did you feel happy when you first knew that the hurricane was over?
It was wonderful. And I was very happy. And one of the nicest things out of the storm was that when all the lights were out, until we got our electricity back on, the stars in the sky at night were really beautiful, like I've never seen before.
Panhandle Strong is just another way of saying that people who have lived here in Panama City want to recover from the catastrophe that they experienced in the storm. And this community is very important to them, and so they're willing to put in the work and everything it takes to recover and to stay here to make the city a stronger, better place. Well, I actually left during the storm, and I was gone for the day before the storm, the day of the storm, the day after the storm. But then I came back and I couldn't get anywhere close to my house. So I went and stayed with some friends who live about 30 miles north of the city until I was able to work on my house well enough to get back in.